It's that time of the year again when grand fireworks displays light up the heavens, giving us an enormous explosion of energy. Interesting to note that while fireworks over Sydney Harbour usually symbolize the start of global festivities, it's actually not the first country to welcome the new year. It's actually the Pacific island of Tonga. While tiny islands in the U.S., Baker and Howland Islands, are the last to ring in the new year. Now, before we go wow, as we count down to the last of 2019 and welcome 2020 with a burst of lights in the sky, let's first speak with Jovinson Ong of Dragon Fireworks, Southeast Asia's largest fireworks company. Good morning, Jovan. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning.
This is like our yearly date. We have this conversation every year.
Yes.
So I guess for comparison, how are sales doing this year?
Sales for this year as a whole, for the industry, I think it's almost the same or slightly lower.
Mm-hmm. And why is that?
A lot of people have this misconception that they cannot use fireworks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they think there's a ban. We would like to thank the president because he didn't really ban manufacturing and distribution anymore. So he left it to the LGU. But the LGU, when they look at the EO 28, Section 1 talks about firecrackers. So they pretty much think that firecrackers means everything. So pyrotechnics, which is in Section 2, allows the use of the smoke like fountains, sparklers. You can use it in your houses, you know. So
this is the same problem from last year, the confusion EO 28.
Yeah, and the terminologies, mm-hmm. Yeah.
So just to be clear, firecrackers would be things that make a lot of noise.
When the primary effect is sound.
This would be Judas Belt,
Judas Belt, the single bangers that we call them. Yeah,
so. And pyrotechnics, which is your specialty, would be the lights.
The lights.
The lights.
We're fountain sparklers, the aerial.
You still make firecrackers?
No more, no more.
No more.
We stopped our firecracker division because you know, the president doesn't really like firecrackers. Mm-hmm. And for us, well, we would like to lower the casualties every year, the injuries brought about by it. Mm-hmm. So we have to sort of like set an example for everybody.
You know, there was a report that cited another group of fireworks retailers.
Yes.
And they were saying that this year the manufacturers were given permits and licenses late, so they weren't able to produce enough, which is the reason why prices are jumping. Is that accurate based on your experience?
The expiration of our manufacturer's licenses is in June. So normally manufacturers would start renewing as early as February or March. Mm. So the PNP actually decided to release it on June itself. Mm. So some people might think that they will not be renewed, but for us, we still manufactured there, you know, we continuously manufactured for as long as the license is there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For those who want a historical perspective, 2017 sales were down, correct? 2017 sales were on a down
industry,
because of smuggling.
Yes.
2018 last year was a great year for you.
For everyone.
For everyone, because?
Because there were, supply was lacking. Because there was no smuggling.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, they got caught in China.
Not here, in
Not
China.
Not here, they got caught in China. So the consolidators who actually facilitates the smuggling got caught in China and were meted the prison sentences.
Of 5 years?
I heard 5 years, uh-huh. Yeah.
And this year?
They found a way again. So there's a lot of smuggled products in the country again.
Mm-hmm. And earlier you mentioned that you're the biggest in Southeast Asia, but
that is ISO certified.
ISO certified.
Yeah.
But really, your biggest competitor would be the smuggled.
Yeah, I think smuggling in the Philippines is the perennial problem of manufacturers. Mm-hmm. That's why we see we have a lot of OFWs, right? Because a lot of countries would like our labor force. They find Filipinos really good, but they don't want to invest in the country. Mm-hmm. So
Because
you're manufacturing and you pay all the taxes, you pay everything, and here comes the smugglers. They don't pay. They just pay the consolidators. They pay some, facilitators to bring in their goods with no taxes.
I remember you estimated before that in 2017 around 200 container vans of smuggled fireworks were brought into the Philippines. Do you have estimates for this year?
I'd say about 80 to 100.
Not as big.
Not as big, but that's substantial. Mm-hmm. That's substantial to swamp the, because depending on the kind of materials they're importing the products. This year they imported more in pyrotechnics, mm-hmm. but we see that there were also some piccolo, you know, the firecracker that's always the bane of the industry, because these are the ones that's really causing at least half of the injuries. Mm-hmm. So piccolo's back. And then I heard there's imported Watusi. So it's already gone. Watusi is no one's manufacturing in the Philippines anymore. But then to have this imported, you know, so we're fearing that if Watusi mm-hmm. causes injuries again because of ingestion by the kids, then that's going to be blamed on us again. So mm-hmm. yeah, the industry is really, the legitimate industry is really in a tight bind. Mm-hmm. Every year we're blamed for something, for a product that is competing with us, and then when they cause harm, everything's blamed on us as well. So mm-hmm. that's what they're
at. And it's so ironic, because earlier we were talking and you said, you know, we're the biggest, but when you look at the market share, smuggled products yeah. beat us.
Yes. No, they cannot claim they're number one, yeah, because they don't have a factory mm-hmm. in the first place, yeah? So. Mm-hmm.
And these products are usually coming from China.
All of them are from China.
Okay. Yeah. I know that you've been having plans to export our products to other countries. Yes. Have we started? How are we?
The permits, we're starting off with the U.S. because that's the most feasible. Mm-hmm. There are more interest from the U.S. now. We've had more American guests coming in, mm-hmm. looking at our factory, our products, everything. But it's not that easy to get the permit to in the U.S. for our products to be brought in. Mm-hmm. So just the paperwork alone, you know, we submit a paperwork and then they'll find some problem with the paperwork. Mm-hmm. They'll ask us to change, and then later on they'll find another thing like that. So, it's a process.
Realistically speaking, when do you see Dragon Fireworks finally exporting?
I think
to the U.S. or Europe, because those were the two markets that were in your wish list.
The Europe one will be harder because we need CE certification mm-hmm. prior to shipment. Mm-hmm. So we cannot, we don't have a CE certifying body in the Philippines mm-hmm. for fireworks.
Okay.
We have CE for other products, but they don't, when we ask the certifying bodies over here if they could actually include fireworks, they don't find it as profitable.
So, and compelling, because there are only a few players.
We'd probably be the only one who's going to be asking them to certify, right?
So realistically, what is the timetable like?
Hopefully, we'll get the permit done by next year. Mm-hmm. And if they place in orders, shipment will be in the first quarter of 2021.
Ah, that's exciting. For the U.S. The U.S.
For the
will
US.
Be first.
Yeah, hopefully.
Okay, so, you know, it's not only during New Year's that your business actually is on a roll, because you joined pyrotechnic competitions.
Yeah.
And last year, we were the champions.
We're the champions in the number one competition mm-hmm. in the world. So if you're in the fireworks industry, that's the sort of like the pinnacle of winning
as
that competition.
But this year, you did not join.
Yes.
And that is because why?
There were a lot of uncertainties whether fireworks was still going to be licensed, permitted to be manufacturing or not. So we deemed it, because we lose money whenever we join competitions and represent the country, because we don't get any subsidy for this. So we have, we sponsor everything. The budget given to us by the organizers is not enough to cover.
How much is the budget? Very curious.
Depends on the competition. The one in Montreal, which is, we consider the Olympics of fireworks display competitions, they give up sort of like, in dollars, about 60,000, so about 3 million. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the uncertainty, is it also, you mentioned uncertainty several times in this conversation so far, is the uncertainty also stopping you from expanding aggressively? From even going public? Because I remember this, 2 years ago we had a conversation about you guys going public.
This business is really hard because 1992, the law was enacted to legalize fireworks manufacturing, distribution, and use. Mm-hmm. As early as 93 or 94, there's a bill that was filed to make it illegal again, to ban fireworks. So our business has been growing. We've been growing the manufacturing facility with the ban looming on our heads, right? So I can actually, you can pretty much think that not a lot of people would actually go, would like to manufacture in the country because of this looming ban. So it's just us who deemed it that, you know, because of business, you know, we tend to expand and expand and expand.
Of course, this business, you are the first generation. You started this business with your brother.
I started it when I was 26.
Very young age. And so it's not a very easy industry to be in.
Clearly. Yes.
And you mentioned that it's very hard to grow aggressively, to plan aggressively when you've got the ban looming on you.
Yes.
Let's talk about your manufacturing size, because I also remember about a year or 2 years ago, you said you were forced to downsize to just by 40% your workforce in manufacturing because of all of these challenges. How are you today? How big is your workforce today?
We've increased a little since then, a little. But the capacity has grown because we've imported a lot of machineries.
Overall, do you get a sense that people are moving away from fireworks in general, that there is a collective effort to ditch fireworks and go for the seemingly safer, more eco-friendly ways of ringing in the new year?
That's
minus the nostalgia, because we know how fireworks has been part of our childhood.
So fireworks, you know, that's really very sad, because this is a tradition of Filipinos, and we should not change our culture. And the fact that we see that some people opt to go abroad, spend their money there, actually the economy of the Philippines is getting hit. We tend to think about tourists coming in, but what we fail to understand is if we actually limit the number of people going out on the new year and they spend it over here, that contributes a lot to the economy. If a lot, you hear a lot of stuff, hey, I have some friends coming over, I have relatives from the US coming over, we need to buy more fireworks because we have special guests coming in. So you hear that, and then you say, okay, they come in, they come to the Philippines because it's lively here. Imagine if there's no fireworks being set off and everybody's just sleeping, isn't it? You actually encourage people to go away, go abroad and spend it there when they think that it's livelier in the other countries. So I think economically, there's a very big compelling reason for fireworks not to be banned. It has to be celebrated. We just need to make sure that the fireworks that ends up in the hands of the public are the safe ones.
Are the safe ones, legitimate ones. And of course, the good news is, you know, even if people have been going abroad, a lot of them are coming home yesterday and today. So you're expecting sales to jump again today?
Jumped yesterday. It jumped already. So we see that sales is becoming, you know, compressed into the last 2 days. And if you have a business that is, you know, you manufacture the whole year, and basically the last 2 days, that's the only time that you're gonna know whether, you know, your product's actually sold or not. You know, you can just feel the stress that we feel.
I imagine the pressure. But Jovan, thank you so much for joining us. I look forward to speaking to you 1 year from now again.
Hopefully
with a better narrative as well. Thank you very much, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. And